Sveiki, and welcome back to your irregular Latvian business review. This week in the news, I saw that the report on Latvian startups was released. It's not a report I have consulted previously, but I was happy to find out that Latvian startup culture is very alive and growing. And I thought I'd share with you what I learned. So, let's go! Let me start my screen record and let's have a looky at the report. So the first graph that made me a little bit sad is this one. I know that business in Latvia has always been concentrated around Riga, but it's really sad to see that in 2025 still there seems to be one city if you want to do business, and the regions are really, really lagging behind. So here we see a map of how many startups there are registered by region in Latvia, and as you see, by far most of them are in Riga, a dynamic that I wish to see change in the future. So the first thing that impressed me was what they call the biggest shakeup of 2024. Two print-on-demand companies, Printful and Printify, have been rivals for many, many years and have now merged. Printful actually is the first and only Latvian unicorn, a startup that has reached a value of $1 billion. And if you look at their websites, they look pretty impressive with global reach, with offices overseas in US. And if you look at their careers page, you can see that you can choose to work in the US, the UK, Canada, Mexico, and many, many more places. So impressive. And now both of these are going to be one company. So there's that. In other news, there's a company called Origin Robotics, which has received a lot of money from the EU Defense Fund, 4.5 million euros, and raised approximately the same in private investments. And they are making drones for the military that can detect objects with their lasers. Overall, seem very, very powerful. And as you know, drones are the new technology of the battlefield in the 21st century. So I'm glad to see that this is one of the most well-performing Latvian startups, a defense industry player. You can check out their website if you're interested. And there's also a company called Submerge Baltic, which is making underwater drones. So they started just by wanting to make drones, but then they saw that many people were doing that, and so they made drones that function underwater. And at first they were meant for like kind of recon and finding rescue missions, I think. They are operational for days, but now they are adapting them for defense purposes. So yeah, hopefully that also works out and Latvia becomes a really important player in defense. That would be great. Something that might be interesting for people like me who work in communication, there's a company called Rival Sense. And what they are offering is they're offering to monitor competitors of any given company and send you weekly reports, but not just data dump, but apparently with actionable insights. I have learned in my university course that actionable insights, converting data to actionable insights, is the thing to have if you are working in communication. Honestly, kind of excited to see if I can afford them. They are not cheap. Definitely happy to see a Latvian company going in this direction. Personally, keeping my eye out for that one. For many years, I've been under the impression that other Baltic countries are leading the way in fintech or finance technology, but it turns out two of the startups mentioned with honorable mentions in the report this year are actually in this industry. There is an app called Mintos, which is basically an investment opportunity that bypasses traditional banks. Personally, not an expert, I am scared of everything that involves non-traditional financial dealings, but as it was mentioned as one of the top growing startups, might be worth checking it out. And Jeff's app, which started as a credit comparing app, when now is has a way of giving loans or securing loans for people who wouldn't normally qualify for a loan. So they are focusing on the emerging world market, looking at people's phone usage, shopping habits, and etc. to kind of evaluate their own risk about giving these people a loan. It's claimed to unlock loans for people in the third world, but as somebody who can't stop hearing about data privacy, I am also kind of scared of it. Again, not an expert, but they have this place called Jeff Data. Get the digital footprint of your user that you can use in fraud prevention, machine learning, and automated business decisions. From Microsoft, X, Skype, Instagram, LinkedIn, Facebook. Anyway, that's one successful Latvian startup. Let's move on to something that doesn't terrify me. Biotechnology. There's a company called Printimed who are making spider silk, artificial spider silk, but it functions like the real thing. They list many uses for it on their websites, but the one that blew my mind is that they are now pivoting towards using this material in 3D live tissue printing, and also they can use it as scaffolding for like organs that need repair or for skin repair. It's just mind-blowing. I wish their website had more videos to show actually how this works, because I find it super interesting. But yeah, things like bladder reconstruction and bone regeneration. I'm so proud that Latvians are working with such innovative and just out there kind of ideas. And another one that I noticed was called Cellbox Labs. So they are creating miniature organs from semiconductors, so not, I think, real. So they are micro-engineered channels that mimic how real human organs work, and that allows them to test new drugs. So again, amazing. They don't tell us much more, but they allow to test new drugs, and that of course leads to maybe curing some of the diseases that humanity is suffering from. Another great initiative in which Latvia is leading the way. So yes, that's what I wanted to tell you about. Unu viss, I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you, like me, were not very educated on what Latvian business is doing, now you know more, and if you want to know more about any of these companies or read the report, the links will be in the description. Ah, and final thought. This year has not really been a year of extreme growth. 2021 was a boom in investment in startups post-pandemic, and ever since then it's been going down. However, it's interesting to see, and it's encouraging to see, that the network and the connections and platforms for investors and for startups and how to put them together are really developing in Latvia. People are sharing their experience, and in this report also, if you are interested, there's a bunch of areas that you can explore if you yourself want to get involved in business or financing business, or just keep up to date like me here from my couch. That's all. Okay, I think that's all that I can give you today. I wish you a lovely Sunday. Bye.